Hey guys, Gator Mom here. I'm doing a quick little video for you guys this morning on how I pack up my preschoolers' on-the-go art kits, if you will. We use these a lot when we go out to eat, different restaurants, doctor's offices, if we're going to be in the car longer than I had anticipated. So I always have one of these full in my car bag as well as whatever diaper bag I'm carrying. It just makes for easy entertainment for them. So I have a 5-year-old and a 3-year-old, so this is all geared for that age range. I'll kind of show you, this is right here is my current one that I have packed up in my diaper bag. And then I'll show you just kind of some other little ideas that I use and how I structure their art kits for when we're out and about. I hope this camera angle is okay. I've been playing with it and I just can't seem to get it right for me. So I hope that this is going to work out for y'all and you can really get an idea of what I'm going to be showing you. So I'll just go ahead and get right into it. This here is a 31 clear pocketed tote, and I've done a video review on this case before for different purposes. I use these for a ton of different things. But right now what I've been using lately is for my on-the-go art kit. So I have it, like I said, in my car bag and then as well as my diaper bag. And then sometimes I'll condense all this, of course, depending on what bag I'm carrying. If I'm carrying a smaller bag, this is obviously not going to fit in it. But I'm finding that this pouch is working the best for my bags lately. So I will show you kind of what I have packed up in here now and then some other ideas of things that I pack in it when I go out. So in here, I just have two little kind of, these are like cards that I got at the, where did I get these at? I got these at Cracker Barrel. Cracker Barrel, you guys, is a great place to find little kids' busy stuff. We have one by our house that we go to all the time, and these here actually came in a pack of 4, but these are just the 2 that I have thrown in there right now. It's Old Maid and Go Fish, and these are fantastic. They just... I'll save the time of showing them to you, but my kids love these. So I have those in there right now, nice, small, and compact. Then I have a little handheld Guess Who game. And this, believe it or not, I got from, I don't know, some fast food restaurant that we went through. This was like a little toy and a kid's meal, and my kids love it. Like, it's perfect. It's just a little tiny travel, like, Guess Who game, and there's different, like, boards you can switch out. It's just, it's been, like, probably the... like the hot item these days. So I have those in there. Then I have a couple of these little picture books. And these, again, I got at Cracker Barrel. Great little books. This one has hidden pictures in it. My son really likes this one. Just kind of like picture searches in here. And then this one here, my daughter's really into, it's the differences between the pictures. So you'll, you know, have 2 of the same pictures and you need to spot what the differences in the pictures are. So they really like these. These are great little books. They were like $1.50, you guys. It was like best purchase ever. But they have a whole display of these of all different kinds. So these are just 2 that we're using right now. Then I have a bunch of Crayola twistable colored pencils. I like to use colored pencils when I'm out because crayons tend to melt. Being in Florida, it's really, really hot. So if I have to keep this in my car for a long period of time, the crayons will melt. I will sometimes keep markers in here, which I actually have some in here now. I like to use those when we're out because I don't let them use them at home unless I'm right next to them because we get marker everywhere. So these are great for when you're out in your art kits. I also have 2 of these little books here, and I think I had these in a couple of my other videos, but these were in the dollar spot at Target. Fantastic finds. I love the dollar spot at Target. That's where I get majority of all this stuff. But these are just little, this one's all about dogs, all different kinds of dogs. It will go through the different breeds, their height, their weight, their color, what they like to eat, what kind of dogs they are, and it's really fun for the kids to kind of learn and look through. This one's all about dinosaurs. So there's a bunch of different, there's some about horses and sharks. And so these are really fun books. So we have those in there. I have one of these again from the Target Dollar Spot. This is just a dry erase boards and a little dry erase marker to do letters on. My son's in kindergarten, so he's been learning how to do his letters. So this is great. He likes that a lot. And then I always keep, these little playing packs. You guys have seen these in all of my videos. I always have these. But I always have one for each of them packed up because they tend to, of course, fight over them. They're in the fighting age. So this one here is just my son's Ninja Turtle one. And I have in here some stickers, the little coloring book that came with this play and pack. And then I'll put in a little notebook in here for them. He also has these little kind of Crayola crayons and then a pencil. These up here are little, these are actually My Little Pony gel pens, but he loves them. He actually has two in his backpack right now at school. He has one of these little notebooks and he draws on it when he's waiting in the car line. So I need to find some boy gel pens for him, but he's been loving these. So I always, like I said, have one of these packed up for each of the kids. This is my daughter. She's a little Hello Kitty notebook. She has markers actually in her. She loves coloring with markers. So I have some of those in there for her. So it just makes it easy. Sometimes if I'm carrying a really small bag, I'll just grab these two and I'm good to go. Like it's just, it's perfect. So then the only other thing I have in here are two little packs of stickers. We are a sticker family. We are a Band-Aid family. I mean, we have stickers and Band-Aids everywhere. So these are really awesome too. My dad actually sent these to them in a little grandpa care package that he sends them kind of weekly. These are from Hobby Lobby. So there's a bunch of different stickers in here. So that's everything that I can fit in one of these clear pocketed totes. And as I was explaining, I do tend to switch out what I carry in these totes. So what I'll do is I have one of these little 31... oh my gosh, I think they're called carry-alls or something, I forget. I'll put the link to all these below if you guys want to know where I got them and everything. But I just have all like little kind of travel things in here. So what I'd like to do is switch out what I keep in that bag to kind of keep it fresh, if you will, for them. And then sometimes I'll just have stuff that I only let them play with when we're out. And then I keep that usually like in our little car box of toys or whatnot. But all I keep in here is all, like I said, the little stuff that I can switch out in that pocketed tote, or if I'm carrying a zipper pouch or whatever I'm carrying. So all that's really in here is a bunch of different kind of notebooks for them. My kids love just plain paper. This is just different crayons and colored pencils I can switch out. This is just stickers. These are a bunch of coloring books that I got out of these play-in packs. So when they're like halfway done with the actual pack, I'll pull the coloring books out because they never color the entire thing. So I just keep them so that I can switch out like what their coloring books that they're playing with in these little packs. And then this is just another little dollar spot notebook. Awesome. These little brain quest things are awesome, you guys. This one is geared more towards my daughter right now. My son did have it for a while, but you know, now that he's older, he's kind of passed it down to her. So this is for the ages 4 to 5. It's preschool. And they're just a bunch of questions and answers. They're double-sided. We have a bunch of these. So I always try to carry one of these in my bags when I can, just to kind of do that with them. These are two more of these fun fact books. This is the shark one. This is the little bug one. And, oh, this was something I think I touched on in one of my other videos also. Got this again at Cracker Barrel. It's Rory's Story Cubes, and my kids love this. We have such a good time with this little box. But they're 9 little dice, and basically you shake the dice and you put them in here, and then you can tell a story with, there's a couple different games that you can play over here, but the one that we do is you look at all the different pictures, and you have to tell everybody a story. And all the pictures have to be in your story. So it's, oh my gosh, it's so funny. My kids are hysterical, like the different stories they come up with and the names. And it's just, this is a really, really fun thing. I love this. Then these are just two more little playing cards, like the Go Fish and the Old Maid. This one's Robot Rummy and Crazy Eight. So we switch those out sometimes. And that's all that I have in this little thing that I usually keep it kind of near where I pack up my diaper bag and whatnot so I can just switch them out. Another pouch that I will use sometimes when I'm out are these big 31 zipper pouches. And this one actually, I've had both of these forever. They're like, they're so old, they're dirty, they're gross. But I thought I would bring them out to show you guys the kind of the size of them. This one here is, we actually keep all of our little flashcards and whatnot in here. So as you can see, it's super unorganized, and I should probably go through and like paperclip some of these together. But my daughter's learning her letters, and some of these are just like color shapes. You guys kind of get the deal. But they're just a bunch of playing cards, but I wanted to pull this out to show you the size of it and kind of how it's structured. And these are great for when you have like a big backpack and you're out and about. You can kind of fill a little bit more in these zipper pouches. This one here, I actually keep, this is like the one I got my daughter forever ago, but we keep this in our garage most of the time, which is kind of funny, but sometimes when we're out front and we're playing and my husband's doing the lawn or whatever we're doing, my daughter loves to just color. She likes to sit in the yard with a big blanket, me and the baby and her, and we just color. So I keep this in the garage next to the bubbles and the sidewalk chalk and all that kind of stuff. And the only thing I have in here is a little, this is a little 31 zipper pouch, and it's thermal. They don't make this size anymore. It's actually a little bit bigger of one, but the only thing I have in here is a ton of crayons, and it's thermal, so I can keep it in the garage. The crayons won't melt. It's fantastic. So that's all that's in this little kind of pouch, if you will. But inside here, which the whole reason I brought it here was to show you kind of capacity wise what these will hold, is a bunch of stickers. This she was actually just drawing with the other day. But these are just little papers and stickers, and this is a coloring book here. And then in here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 coloring books I have that fit in here. And you can, I mean, you could fit even more in there, as you can see. So these little zipper pouches are, they're fantastic for this kind of art stuff. I just love them. I must have hundreds of them around my house for different stuff. So this, like I said, is what we keep in our garage, but I will sometimes use one of these instead of that clear pocketed tote for my on-the-go art kit.